miracle. Let go of my miracle. I carry my miracle from you today. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and begin to declare.
Is so because there is a strong man
people in the island don't go with God. 90% of believers, 90% of born again Christians, I'm even saying 90%, like 95 or 98%. They just go to church, but after church they live their normal life. There is a force that is blocking the church of God from moving forward. Praise God. You can, when you work, by the time you leave this church, you meet people so in other places. You will not be able to differentiate whether they were in church or not with those who were not in church. They flock together. They do the same thing. If it is woman, they are there. Beer, they are there. Smoking, they are there. So as unbelievers are out there smoking, then when they leave church, they will smoke. As the unbelievers are out there drinking, when they leave church, they will go and drink. Praise God. There are some people, although they are in church this morning, they have appointment with alcohol. They have appointment with alcohol. We are going to pray and break that force, that stronghold that is blocking the church from marching forward, blocking salvation of the people of God in this island. We are going to break it into pieces. Open your mouth and pray in the name of Jesus. Begin to pray. Begin to destroy it. Yes, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say in the name of Jesus. I didn't hear that. Say in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Any strong man.
Any strong man.
Blocking the growth of the church. Receive the fire of God.
Receive the fire of God.
In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to pray.
The growth of the church. Receive the fire of the Holy Ghost. Against you when you are anointed with the Holy Ghost. When somebody was fired to destroy you, in the mighty name of Jesus, and it's not much fighting against the growth of this church, that he doesn't want the church to grow, that he doesn't want the establishment of Christians. Fire of the Holy Ghost destroy them. Fire of the Holy Ghost dismantle them. We come against them. We destroy their plans. We destroy their territory. We cover that they are using against the church of God.
In Jesus' name. Yes, he prayed. Let us read that Ephesians chapter 1. I thought it was already on board. That Ephesians chapter 1, we are going to read it. Please, you are standing. We are still praying. We're going to pray at least two prayer points again, and then we move on to the next thing. Verse 17, and the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that he may know what is the hope of his calling and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of the power of his power to us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power. Now, the Paul was praying for Philippian church that God should give them revelations for their eyes to be enlightened. A revelation means illumination, like something were in darkness, or you were in a dark room and you could not see anything but a light came. So a revelation is a light. It's a discovery of a secret. That's a revelation. Praise God. And when you discover a secret, then you have a better understanding of the situation. So that's why Paul says that give them the spirit of wisdom and the revelation of the knowledge of you, that their eyes will be enlightened and they will come to know the riches of the glory and the inheritance that has been reserved for the saints. So on Friday all night, it was very powerful. I was teaching there on blindness. I was teaching on blindness. And I make a reference to this verse. And we did some pertinent prayer. Because the reason we are where we are and we are suffering what we are suffering is because of our blindness. Though you are seeing. So Jesus looked at the Pharisees and he told them that they are the blind of the blind. Why did he say that? Because they were living in error. There were things around them they did not understand. They did not have a revelation of who Jesus was. So he caused them that they were blind. Praise God. So when you are blind, you are unconscious of your environment and the circumstances around you and your atmosphere, your spiritual atmosphere. You are blind. When you are blind, you don't understand your spiritual atmosphere. So things can happen to you and you don't even know. So we are going through some things and we don't know the cause. Why? Because our spiritual mind are blinded. I make a reference to 2 Kings chapter 6, where the king of Syria will plan against the king of Israel in his chambers, in his palace. But Elijah will know it and reveal it to the king of Israel. And before the king of Syria knew it, the king of Israel has had their plan. And then the king of Syria began to persecute his own men, that there is a traitor among us who always go to the king of Israel to reveal every plan that we plan in these chambers. Praise God. And then one of his servants said, "No, Lord," he said, "there is a man of God in Israel who always reveal the king everything you speak, even in your bedroom." Praise God. So listen, hear me, when you have revelation, when your eyes are open, there can be no secret plan against your life. The devil can never plan anything evil against you without God revealing it to you. Are we understanding something? Praise the Lord, somebody. So every plan was revealed to Elijah, and Elijah revealed it to the king. Hello? We are going to pray. We are going to tell God, "God, open my eyes. Let my eyes begin to see, that I will be able to see every sacred plan against me. Everything I am suffering, Lord, open my eyes so that I will get to know them. Give me revelation of my life, revelation of my destiny, revelation about my marriage, revelation about my finance." Open your mouth and begin to pray that prayer. Pray in the name of Jesus. I didn't, oh my God, you don't even understand me. That's why you're not praying. Never shut.
That my Lord, you open my right to see.
There are going to be a revelation. There are going to be a revelation.
Let it be a revelation.
A revelation. A revelation.
Let it be a revelation.
Yes.
Let it be a revelation of everything that
I do. Let it be a revelation. We are going to pray and say, "Lord, any evil plan against my destiny, expose it, reveal it, make it known Open your mouth and begin to pray. Pray in the name of Jesus.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, any evil plan against my life, expose it to me. In the mighty name of Jesus, reveal it to me, Lord. Expose any evil plan that the devil is planning against my life. Expose it. Let me see the name of Jesus. Open it to me, Lord. Let me know. Let me see any plans of the evil. Let me see any plans wherever that is run against me. Wherever that they call on me.
In the name of Jesus, can the church stand up? I want everybody to stand up and receive a prayer from me. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. Thank you, Holy Ghost. The Rabahando, Bakalabato Sukote, Makatoko Dobo Sakari Katala, Shakatebo. Lord, I don't know the force that has been sitting on their destiny. I don't know the witch and the wizard that has been cooking their finance, sitting on their lives right now. By the power of the Holy Ghost, I command that pot to break now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I break every satanic pot. I break every satanic bonds. I destroy every satanic fire.
Amen.
Every witch wizard sitting on your destiny.
Jesus.
I command fire to destroy the bonds.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Jesus.
I command the bonds to be cut to begin to be hot, very, very hot now.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I increase the temperature on their bonds.
Yes.
They won't be able to sit anymore.
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Anywhere your name is mentioned and padlock by the power of the Holy Ghost,
Jesus.
I command that lock to open.
Amen.
I unlock every lock that has been used to lock your destiny.
Yes.
Every lock that has been used to lock your finance.
Jesus.
Every lock that has been used to lock your marriage.
Jesus.
I command the fire of God,
yes,
to destroy that lock.
Jesus.
By the power of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Jesus.
My Lord and my God, I pray that your power come down mightily upon your children.
Jesus.
Let every yoke that has been holding their lives, let that yoke be broken.
Jesus.
Because of the anointing.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
I decree that, Lord, a miracle shall locate them today.
Yes.
By the hand of the Lord, let them receive a miracle.
Jesus.
A miracle of their lives. Lord, let it come upon their lives.
Yes,
in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Jesus.
I command their eyes to be opened.
Amen.
Every condition, make it a secret place.
Yes.
Again, their life, Lord, expose it. Expose their enemies.
Yes.
Hear me. I'm going to prophesy the life of someone now. The Lord says that when you live here,
yes,
your enemy will be exposed to you.
Amen.
There are some things and some people very close to you, you never knew the way they were. But after the meeting, you are going to discover them.
Amen.
You are going, Jesus, to discover their secret plan against your life.
Yes, Lord.
You are going to discover that they are working against you though they smile with you.
Jesus.
That is what the Lord is saying.
Hey.
That's what I'm receiving. He said, some secret will be revealed to you.
Amen.
Some secret will be revealed to you.
Jesus.
And listen, there are some issues in your life, in your family. The Lord says, even in the dream of the night,
Jesus,
he is going to reveal it to you.
Amen.
Like he did to Daniel. He did to Daniel.
Jesus.
He revealed a secret to Daniel in the dream.
Yes.
And he says, I should speak to his children.
Yes.
That he is still the God of Daniel.
Yes.
And that there are secrets he is going to reveal to you in your dream.
Amen.
So listen to me. After this meeting, any dream that you dream, please don't take it for granted. Hallelujah. Yes.
Amen.
If you can't understand it, make sure you meet me so that we talk about it.
Yes.
Because there are some things that God will begin to reveal.
Amen.
There are some secrets in your family that the Lord will begin to reveal to you in a dream.
Amen.
Is the Lord that is saying, it's not me. I didn't plan to say all this. Hallelujah.
Amen.
My Lord and my God, I pray for your power upon the church. I pray that your glory be released upon this church. Amen. Let the anointing for wealth, anointing for stability, anointing for fitness, anointing for speed, let it come upon this meeting. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord, everyone under the canopy of a tree. Anyone under the canopy of wood trees, Lord, shall never be frustrated. Doors shall be opened unto them. Because of the anointing upon this ministry. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, I prophesy unto the church that, Lord, you are going to open great doors. You are going to open great doors.
Amen.
You will cause your power to grow in this
Lord.
Ministry.
Amen.
The Lord, as many will enter here, in any of the cities, their story will change.
Amen.
Their table will be turned around in their favor.
Yes.
Their predicament will become history. And their expectation will be called their now.
Yes.
I didn't hear that. Amen.
Amen.
Expectation, what they are hoping for, will become their now in the name of Jesus. Maraka toroba ya inakatosa hey mahina wokataba likato sete makato prakata la makate resoso sete kata prakato koto kata kata rakato koto. I don't know what has been holding you. It's going to let you go right now. The power of God in the name of Jesus, move, touch, karaya. Touch. Release their destiny. Release their life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Release their finance. In the mighty name of Jesus. I bind every force of darkness. Every spirit of delay, stagnancy spirit, setback spirit, I confront you today by this anointing. I chase you out of the life of the people of God. The power of God, in the name of Jesus, move. The Lord is destroying some things. I'm just receiving. The Lord says he's destroying some things. He's destroying some things. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Lord. If there is any sickness on your body, it's going out right now. Any sickness is leaving you right now. Any infirmities. I don't know whatever health condition that has been putting you down right now. I speak to you. Rise above that situation. Rise above that sickness. Rise above that disease. Be it high blood pressure, be it cancer, be it tumor, whatever it is, Hakaraba, hepatitis B, rubber osteitis, gastric, proroshake, telebayakako, brakata, whatever you have been diagnosed of, is it fibroid? Power of God, in the name of Jesus, move! Let them be healed now. Healing anointing. Healing and the garment of healing has been released in the house. Receive your healing. 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 Be healed in your blood. In your veins. Be healed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every tissue in your body, receive the healing power of God. Your bones be healed. Your head be healed. Your eyes be healed. Every part of your body be healed. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I release the fire of God in the house. The Lord said you are carrying a miracle. I don't know who he's talking to, but you are carrying a miracle. After this meeting, you will see things changing in your life.
Amen.
After this meeting, you are coming to testify.
Amen.
Yes, the hand of the Lord is right here. Prana kobo kitarina kato sakata rebolo to seke tele baya baba. You demon of infirmity, out! Go! 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 You shall creep right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
And they say, say amen. Come on, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen, somebody. Our God is good.